ओके, सो गुड इवनिंग सर एंड बैचमेट. सो वी हैव प्रिपेयर द मार्केट रिसर्च रिपोर्ट एंड बिजनेस प्लान टू डिफरेंटली. सो आवर मार्केट रिसर्च रिपोर्ट इज अबाउट द चैलेंजेस एंड अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन द यूज ऑफ बीटी ब्रिंजल एंड
ओ
एचटीबीटी कॉटन इन द फ्यूचर.
वाह,
सो यस, नेक्स्ट स्लाइड्स प्लीज. सो आवर टीम मेंबर्स आर आरती नवीन, हेमंत संतोष ढंडाळे, पी मोनिका, सायुज्य राज सिंह एंड विशाल गालो. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. विशाल सर. हाँ यस. सो आवर कंटेंट इज इंट्रोडक्शन, बैकग्राउंड, मार्केट रिसर्च एंड रिजल्ट एंड कंक्लूजन. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. सो इंट्रोडक्शन इज द टुडे इज अ मेजर चैलेंज इज टू डेवलप द लो इनपुट एंड हाई आउटपुट एग्रीकल्चर प्रोडक्शन बिकॉज द यस बिकॉज पॉपुलेशन इज ऑल्सो ग्रोइंग इन द इंडियन पॉपुलेशन इज ग्रोइंग एट द हाई रेट एंड वी विल नीड टू प्रोवाइड फूड सिक्योरिटी टू द ऑल द पीपल. सो वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ द बीटी ब्रिंजल इन इट? बीटी ब्रिंजल रिड्यूसेस द 75% ऑफ द स्प्रेइंग टू कंट्रोल पेस्ट एंड एचटीबीटी कॉटन रिड्यूसेस द कॉस्ट ऑफ वीड कंट्रोल. सो वॉट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव वी इंक्लूड इन द मार्केट रिसर्च? सो वी वॉन्ट टू नो अबाउट द चैलेंजेस एंड अपॉर्चुनिटी इन द फ्यूचर, ओपिनियन ऑफ द पीपल अबाउट जीएम क्रॉप्स, कंज्यूमर बिहेवियर एंड देयर एटीट्यूड टू यूज जीएम प्रोडक्ट फॉर कंजप्शन, फ्यूचर डिमांड एंड स्कोप एंड वॉट आर द ड्राइविंग फैक्टर्स एंड कंस्ट्रेंट्स फॉर द जीएम क्रॉप्स इन फ्यूचर. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. हाँ, सो इट इज द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ बीटी ब्रिंजल. इट इज स्टार्टेड इन 2000 एंड इन 2009 जीएसी अप्रूव द 7 बीटी ब्रिंजल हाइब्रिड्स फॉर लार्ज स्केल ट्रायल्स. बट व्हाट हैपन आफ्टर द जीएसी, देयर वेर सम एनवायरमेंटल एंड हेल्थ रिस्क फैक्टर्स वेर एसोसिएटेड विथ इट एंड इट इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू इफेक्ट द बायोडाइवर्सिटी इन द इंडिया. सो द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरमेंट एंड फॉरेस्ट एनवायरमेंट एंड फॉरेस्ट्री हैज पुट द बीटी ब्रिंजल वराइटीज अंडर द कंसिडरेशन. सो इट इज इन द मोरेटोरियम पीरियड फ्रॉम द 2009 टू द प्रेजेंट 2020. सो इन 2020 गवर्नमेंट थॉट टू द टू वराइटीज ऑफ द बीटी ब्रिंजल. सो नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. So, the market research data we collected from the Google form we floated, and we also do the telephonic conversation with some farmers and the people. And for the primary research and for the secondary research, we refer to the various articles, newspaper articles and research paper, and also the government website. So the data we collected is 52% people think that GM crop other than cotton should be permitted for the cultivation in India. 62% people show interest to use BT Brinjal and HT-BT cotton. 52% people who involved in our survey thinks that GM crop saves the cost of pesticides, and 48% people think it gives the more production than traditional varieties. 38 people think GM crop products are not suitable for food consumption. So means the final consumer have some doubts about it. And 38% people think due to the lack of proper government policy, GM crops are not permitted in India. So according to the answer of the consumers, we divided them into the various categories. Like 23% of the people found as early to the technology as early as possible. Then 33% people are early majority, 24% people are as late majority, and 14% people are using only traditional method. The last slide, please. Vishal sir. So we discuss all this point with the team members, and we come to this conclusion that a main challenge today is to develop low input, high output agriculture. So, but this cannot be achieved without the use of innovation. but this does not mean we can undermine the human and environmental health. There need to be extensive research. So all this point we can refer, like the last point, the fifth number point is very important, that science cannot be declared any technology completely risk-free. Genetically engineered crop can reduce some environmental risks associated with conventional agriculture, but will also introduce new challenges that must be addressed. So it is the conclusion given by all of our team members. So thank you. We can go for the business plan.
Yeah.
I'll continue. A very good evening to respected sir and my batchmates. I'm Monica here. We are heading to the business plan of our team, and it is Splash. Next slide, Vishal. So let me introduce you all to my team, who director being Hemant, and Chief Executive Officer Vishal, Chief Finance Officer Saijya, Chief Marketing Officer Naveen, and the head HR, that is me, Monica. Next slide. Our contents include business introduction, market research, SWOT analysis, product description and competitors, promotion and distribution, business finance. Next slide. Okay, introduction. So what is actually Splash Beverages? Splash Beverages is a startup company, which is a zero alcohol refreshing beer brand, proudly Indian. Brand Splash was launched in 2020 with a single-minded vision of catering to a new category of drink that is modern, trendy, and aspirational. So we headquartered our startup at Nashik, and we actually started selling the products in Mumbai, Pune, Nagpur, and Gujarat. We are actually introducing Splash in a strong 330 ml glass bottles, which are dressed up in a beautiful packaging design. And then we pride ourselves in getting our products right with just the right amount of sweetness, brewed impeccably in a natural base of hops, malt, real fresh fruit juice, and a fizz that's enough to pleasantly tantalize your taste buds. We have Splash in two more varieties, that is crafted with lemon and grapefruit. Next slide. Goals and objectives of our startup are to earn and maintain best rating as one of the best refreshing non-alcoholic beverages in India, to establish 30% minimum gross profit margins from inception, achieve a profitable return on investment within 3 years, and attract talented and motivated staff. Next slide. So mission of our Splash startup is, our brand mission is to be our customer's favorite drink and way to refresh. And then vision is to run a long-term sustainable growth in business, consistency in quality, taste and appearance of product. And the core values which we are following are integrity, boldness, honesty, trust, and accountability. Next slide. Thank you.
I would like to continue. Good afternoon, everyone. So for market research, we have looked on major 6 aspects. First one is location. So for location, Splash Beverages team decided to focus on urban areas of Maharashtra, like Monica told about Mumbai, Pune, Nashik, etc. And also it is looking for Telangana urban areas also. Then for activity, during online market survey of Splash, we found that more than 90% of people look for the flavor and more than 80% of people look for the brand. And for the nutrition and all the aspects regarding to health, there were very less people, less than 10% people were looking for that. Then for raw material, third. So raw materials are majorly grapes, orange, lemons, sugars, and water. And also it requires preservatives and sweeteners, which all were being procured by directly through farmers, farm fields, or retail shops, or supermarkets, etc. Then for processing, the products were zero alcohol-based drinks. Then major products were orange-based, lemon-based drinks, and grapefruit drinks. Then regarding to budget, if I talk about like consumer and like for budget, I'll be sharing a graph now, and the finance part will be covered by Saijya, mm-hmm. and responses also we'll be seeing now. So this was the research which have been done online. So the second graph you can see here, 62.5% people refer sweet type of drinks, and followed by spicy and salty. And in the last graphs, you can see like how much price consumers consuming the one drink now. So 40 to 70 is the majority, and this is the product of, this is the price of our product also. Then here you see 91.7% people are in the favor of flavor, like they choose their drink based on their flavor, and 87.5% of means preferring the brand. Then in next, promotion and publicity plan. So how do we promote or publicize our product or our startup? So first one is like keeping the consumers enthusiastic about their health by rewarding on it. Like on the application of Splash, we are organizing some contests or some events which are very interactive and giving the rewards to customers. Then fun challenges for awareness. In that also, we are keeping on application only few challenges for consumers. Then through the social media, so promotion on FB, Instagram to post and stories on Splash.20. Splash.20 is official website of it. And we are doing the promotion of Facebook, Instagram, then keeping daily blogs for health consciousness. Like in the urban areas, people are very health conscious, and the number is still growing. So and making videos and promoting them also. Then by third is similar shape to beer bottle. So people are finding it more attractive to drink in this kind of bottles. Then advertising by posters and TV at every places of Maharashtra and Telangana. Then discounts to membership customers. Like through the challenges and contest which are being held on the application, the membership customers will be getting the discounts. Then exploring benefits of minerals to human body. So through this advertisement also, we are telling that means what are the minerals and vitamins of these drinks are giving, which are not available in other drinks. Am I audible?
Yeah.
Yes.
1 second. The slide is not moving. Then the last one, SWOT analysis. So strength of our industry is shifting of consumer preferences. Like consumer want to leave the alcohol habit and they find a better replacement. So our drink is zero alcohol based, but it gives the slight taste of alcohol, which is shifting the consumers towards this, and low cost of preference production and low cost compared to other competitors. Like if we talk about other major competitors of it, Coolbug and all, so its cost is less. Then its weaknesses, like lack of awareness, like people are not aware about their health and all, they are still consuming alcohol. Then lack of clear cut marketing channels, and workload is high per worker. So like the products are highly perishable, so the workers cannot do it like malt of grains, so because it is highly perishable. And opportunities are special niche product, health conscious people, strong distribution channel, availability of raw material. So raw material is easily available at everywhere, retail shops, supermarkets, regarding to farmers and all. And the people are becoming health conscious by seeing channels or TV or seeing news also. And some of the threats are existing competition, which I have told about Coolbug and all. Then technology failures, like the whole company is automated. The machines are automatic, so technology can fail anytime regarding electricity and all. Then political pressures regarding taxes. So next will be continued by Naveen, sir.
Good evening, sir, and batchmates. I'm going to tell about our product description. As you all know, our product is non-alcoholic beverage, which is available in three different kinds of flavors, that is orange, grape, and lemon. We have, starting up this, we have made a market research. Which are the qualities preferred by the consumers, we are made according to that qualities are added in the our drink. And our product is... It is non-carbonated and low sugar content, because nowadays many people are preferring this non-carbonated drinks because these carbonated drinks can cause this gastric troubles, and sugar content, high sugar content in some soft drinks causing the diabetic people to avoid that. So we have taken these into consideration, and we have made our product, and we use only the natural flavors, which are taken from grapes and oranges. Next slide. In this market, in our category, the major competitors for our product are the Kuhlberg and the Kingfisher Radler, which is made by United Breweries Limited Company. These two are the major competitors in our marketing segment. They both are malt based non-alcoholic beverages mixed with lemonades. And different flavors are added, and here this Kingfisher Radler is a carbonated drink. So
Naveen, you have gone to mute.
Hello.
You went to mute already.
So hello.
Now we can hear you.
Kingfisher Radler is a carbonated drink, so the sales have been getting down gradually. At start, it was going at a good pace, but it has down gradually. And the Kuhlberg is a non-carbonated drink, but it has a high sugar level in it, so it is not preferred by everyone due to the high sugar content in it. And Kuhlberg is a Mumbai startup company which is established in 2016. Our company is also starting in Maharashtra itself, so Kuhlberg is our first major competitor in that region. Next.
Yes, very good.
Next, target market. As we all know, the Indian non-alcoholic beverage market has been growing very much at a rapid pace than even the alcoholic beverages. It is growing at a CAGR at the rate of 9.5% CAGR this year, and it is expected to grow up to 12.345 million dollars in the next year. And that as we have targeted the non-alcoholic beer segment of the market, here this market is widely open because it is not very much occupied. Only 2 or 3 competitors are present, as said in the earlier slide. And we have a good demand in the youth, and we have good demand in youth from urban areas, because in an article I've read that almost 40% of youth are liking to convert from a beer to this non-alcoholic beer. So it has good demand in urban areas and in the youth level also. Market for non-alcoholic beverages has been steadily increasing, but due to this carbonated drinks, it has been stagnated. But after the developments like this soft drinks and some non-carbonated cool drinks, it has been going up once again. Next slide.
Get into the business plan. I think you can rush through this.
The promotion is explained by the Vishal. So I'm just going through the distribution channels. Distribution channels, nothing but we have mainly concentrated in supermarkets and some of the supermarkets and the merchandise which are present in the urban areas, because they are the first primary, they are the our primary targets. And then to capture the rural markets also, we are going to retail shops in urban areas. For the more capturing, we have communicated towards restaurants, bars and pubs are our primary targets, where we can get high income.
Thank you. Thank you. I think R&D, let's skip it.
And business finance?
Yes. I will go through business finance right now. And please, next slide. Yeah, so the setting up of the plant almost cost us around 2,67,50,000, and which included the equipments like beer plant, boiler, and then we also have a juicer and washing bottle washing machine. And there was building cost also and land cost also. Next slide, please. So our production capacity is actually 14,40,000 liters and per month, and our present operational capacity is at 10.5%, which is about 150,000 liters. Next slide, please. Yeah, and these are the salaries that we are paying actually, and this is the right hand side. We can see the cost of production per month. We are acquiring raw materials like barley, hop extract, fruits, and water. And whereas labeling, packaging cost, marketing cost, overhead charges, adding all that, we are accounting about 18,65,000. And whereas the salary expenditure is 24,50,000, which is almost 43,15,000. Next slide. Previous one. Yeah. And this is a we are actually targeting presently. Our targets are retail shops. We are target. We have 150 retail shops which we are targeting. The quantity of bottles that we are giving is 105, and the quantity of 750 ml bottle is 18. So same is with the restaurant and bars. We can see the data over here. And in total, the sale cost that we are acquiring per month is around 2,27,00,000. 77,500. Next slide, please. Okay, and so here we can see our working capital that we need, means salary plus production cost, which is around 43,15,000. Then with the sales that we saw in the previous slide, we are selling about 1,50,000 liters per month. So we are having a profit of 1,84,62,500, and we are giving CSR activity. We are actually giving around 10 lakhs, and we are giving tax cut of 46 lakhs. And then if you will see at our benefit cost ratio, it is actually 4.2, and break even point was 20,000 liters, around 20,000 liters. And the reason for benefit cost ratio is high because we are actually having a low cost of very low cost of production, since we are acquiring raw materials from the local farmers, and there's less transportation cost. So all these plus we are also using water. Water is actually 95% in a beer bottle, 95% of the product is water, and that's why we are actually having very low cost, and that's why high profit and high BNC ratio. Next slide, please. Okay, so we'll end this by the highlights and some other points. See, the Splash was founded in 2020, and demand this idea of Splash came into because we saw the demand of alcohol consuming customers shifting towards non-alcohol, and then we are also looking forward to export these products in Europe and Middle East because of the great demand there, especially in Middle East due to religious purposes. The alcohol is banned there, so that is a great market for non-alcoholic beers. And then we are also using two level channels for distribution. We are using a wholesaler, and then we are giving it to wholesalers. We are selling it to wholesalers. Then wholesalers is selling it to retailers or retail shops or restaurant or pubs and bar. Next slide, please. Thank you, sir. This is our whole business. Thank you, sir.
What is the bottle Splash? I mean, is somebody's brand or you made it?
Right hand side was made by us.
Wow.
That is a logo, sir. Logo.
The right hand side is
Temple. Lovely.